Hey, Donnie Eaton here with Prosperity Mortgage Advisors, and we are once again live from the shop, and you guys are in for a big treat tonight. We got Jason Wagoner. Now, besides the fact that he's a big Arkansas fan, go Big Orange, although it was a horrible week last week, he is awesome, and his voice is perfect for country music, and you're about to hear that right here. He spent a lot of time downtown enjoying you guys coming out and listening to him, and he knows how to bring the house down. So give it up right now for Jason Wagoner.
It all started with a bad case of the slamming door. And ended when the judge said, what's mine is yours. Now I'm sitting on this bar stool next to an old jukebox, trying to find a cure for the what I got. I've got the used to be breaking out all over me. I caught it when she came down with it, set me free. I've got the can't forget, the I wish we'd never met, the teary eyes, swallowed pride, it ain't over yet, it's killing me. I've got the used to be. Don't care about closing time, and the I wish I were dead won't be far behind. I'll wake up tomorrow with the oh, what did I do, and I'll come back to my senses with the I love you. I've got the used to be breaking out all over me. I caught it when she came down, set me free. I've got the can't forget, the I wish we'd never met, the teary eyes, the swallowed pride, it ain't over yet, it's killing me. I've got the used to be, the do without, the kick me out, there ain't no doubt, I've got the used to be.
Talking Jason Wagoner live from the shop, everybody. How are you?
Appreciate
buddy?
You. I'm doing great.
Great
appreciate
to see you, man. Don't leave me hanging. Don't leave me hanging.
Great to be here.
Oh, man, dude. I can't tell you how good it is to have you in the house. We're playing some country music tonight.
Music. That's what we do.
Country music. So that was a Daryl Singletary tune.
Absolutely. Yes.
And I know you were his favorite singer. I mean, you know.
Well, I'll take that anytime.
Well, yeah, absolutely, man. You're a lot of people's favorite singer, but yeah, for to be Singletary's favorite singer is pretty impressive, man.
That's a big one there.
You know, you guys, did you guys ever get to do much together?
We sang a couple times. He'd come down to gigs every now and then, but nah, you know, a couple times, but not a whole lot.
Yeah. Yeah. Have you been playing much? I mean, I know a lot of stuff's kind of slowed
not
down.
Not much. Yeah, I've. Maybe get a gig a month. About a gig a month.
Yeah, it's kind of like my data plan on a gig a month.
Yeah, a gig a month. There
you
go. I like that.
So, but you've been writing a lot.
Oh, yeah. Been writing. Definitely getting back into the writing.
Yeah.
Writing thing. So
well, that's awesome, man.
About that. So, yeah.
And you got some great songs you brought. Those are
they
new?
Original stuff. Yeah, fairly new.
Yeah.
You know, fairly within the last year or two.
Yeah. Awesome. All right. So we're going to do another.
Keith Whitley tune here. One of my favorites by Mr. Whitley.
All right.
When they open the bar, I'll be there on a stool and forget all my cares in a hurry. And it's my belief that I'll find relief bottle of Tennessee curry. Her memory keeps waiting in the light every night, along with the rest of my worries. But I'll never cry. I can hold up the wall with the help of some Tennessee courage. Now my good friend Jack Daniels stands tall on the shelf, and he'll go to war with my troubles, and he'll never desert this old friend when I'm hurt and needing some Tennessee courage. Now straight 90 proof can alter the truth. Put hair on your chest in a hurry, and I know I'll survive. Raise hell for a while with a helper, some Tennessee courage. Now my good friend Jack Daniels stands tall on the shelf, and he'll go to war and he'll never desert this old friend when I'm hurt and needing some Tennessee courage. No, he'll never desert this old friend. Eating some Tennessee curry. So pour me some Tennessee curry.
Oh, one of my favorites by Keith Whitley. Love that song. Vern Gosden actually wrote that song.
Did he really?
Yeah, he sure did.
Did he ever sing it?
Oh, yeah, he had a cut on it too.
Did
yeah,
he really?
Yep, sure did. Awesome.
I don't know how I never heard that song.
I mean, it's out there. Oh, yeah. It's
that's
good.
You got to be ready for a song like that. That's painful.
That is painful. That is deep hurt right there.
Deep hurt.
Deep hurt.
Three verses of deep hurt.
Exactly, yeah.
So you've been writing with, well, are we doing original tune now? Is that
yeah.
what we got?
Yeah, we're going to do a song called Just Another Song. I wrote this with Roger Springer.
Oh, nice.
And Mike Geiger. So two good writers. And we wrote this one here. And
how long ago did you write this?
About 3 years ago.
Yeah?
Something like that.
Is this one on Spotify, I'm sure?
No, yeah. It's not on Spotify.
It's not?
No, I don't have any. I wished I knew how to do all that.
You don't have this out there yet?
I don't have this anywhere.
Somebody needs to pay attention to this right now and find Jason and make sure you do this, because obviously this voice needs to be out there for everyone to hear.
That.
Without a doubt.
Well, that's awesome. We're going to do this one for you, y'all. The first time we heard it, she was sitting next to me in my old pickup truck on our way to Dairy Queen, and we sang along. She laid her head on my shoulders, put her hand on my knee,
And I felt her fingers softly, they tapping out the beat as it played on. It was just another song, it playing on the radio. We were only 17 back then. How were we to know? And when you fall in love, right in the middle of a melody from that moment on, it could never be just another song. Yeah, we slow danced to it at the senior prom, and I could still remember everything about that dress that she had on and that perfume she wore. Then later on that night, down by the lake, she said yes every time. I hear it to this day, it's so much more than just another song. And playing on the radio, and we were only 17 back then. How would we know? When you fall in love, right in the middle of a melody from that moment on, it could never be just another song. Never be just another song. The first time we heard it, she was sitting next to me in my old pickup truck on our way to Dairy Queen, and we sang along. Country music, Roger Springer, Mike Geiger.
Man, that's good stuff.
I love it.
I can't believe that song's not out there for anybody to hear.
Never,
well,
never
until
been
now,
demoed.
Never been. Can't say that now.
Well,
can't
right.
say that now. I mean, I got a fix.
The demo.
I got a fix in it, but I mean, other than that, it's a good demo. Man, Jason, you got to get your stuff out there, buddy.
I know it.
This is like, I mean, your voice. I mean, your voice always, of course. It's like 10 feet thick. I mean, it really is.
It's, I appreciate that.
It literally fills the room. I'm a bass player. You know what I mean? And if it's not thick, I don't really hear
no,
it, you know?
Exactly.
And you are just killing it, man. You
Thank
have an
so
amazing
much.
Voice. You always have. And that's why people always came to see you downtown.
Yeah, that's why we always had a big time.
Yeah. Heck yeah, man.
We played together. We've cut.
Oh, yeah.
Picked a few times.
Oh, yeah, a few times. Hoot was there most of the time.
Oh, yeah. Hoot.
Because, I mean, that's just.
Hoot and
I mean,
Culpepper.
Hoot and Culpepper. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah. How long have you been in town?
I have been in town since 1996.
So, oh, okay.
You know, 24 years.
Yeah, yeah.
Like that, yeah.
That's a long
off
time.
And on. Yeah, I did move home in 2011, but circumstances brought me back about 6 years later, so I would take off 6 years of that. But
yeah. Have you ever had a publishing deal or anything?
I had one back in 98.
Yeah.
I had a small publishing deal. It was with an independent guy.
Yeah.
Never any kind of major publishing deal or anything.
Yeah, like. I can't imagine. You know. You might after this, man. These songs are out there. This is so good.
Let's do it.
This is so good, man. It really is.
Alrighty,
Jason Wagoner, everybody.
If you like red roses right out of the blue for no reason at all, laying in bed for hours on end, doing nothing but laugh and talk. If you like candlelight and warm red wine to celebrate the middle of the week, you're gonna loving me. If you like knowing someone is gonna be there after after a long, hard day, to take the troubles of this cold world and melt them all away. You want someone to reach for the stars with you and help you catch your dream. You're gonna love loving me. Still holding hands, looking back on a life full of memories, still making plans. And drinking coffee and watching the sunrise, sitting on that old porch swing, then you're gonna love loving me. I'm gonna love you like a man woman when he knows it's right. I'm gonna love you like I've never loved anyone in all my life. If in the arms of a man who can't get enough of you is where you wanna be, you're gonna love loving me.
Brought me back so many years. That feel is like,
that's 90s country feel. Right?
But right, that whole vibe is like, I just want to like, I don't even know what it is. I don't know if it's the stage that I'm seeing or, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
You walk into the stage and you would hear that kind of a vibe, and that's just like so cool, man. That is great. And you wrote that.
Yeah, me and Roger Springer and Mike Geiger again, we wrote that.
Golly, man, that is good.
Had a good
stuff.
Run with those guys.
Yeah, right? How many did you guys write?
I wrote about 10 or 12 songs.
Really? Jason, I'm telling you, buddy, you got to get this out there. You have got to get this stuff out there.
I just get lazy about stuff, and just life happens sometimes.
Well, you know what? Life definitely happens, but now you'll have this, and you can at least take this and say, all right, this is what I do, because what you do is just amazing. Amazing.
Thank you. Having a lot of fun.
Oh, it's great, man.
Yeah, Haggard music.
It's not love, but it's not bad. It's one of my favorite Haggard tunes.
She was always there each time I needed you, holding on to me like I held on to you. And we still don't have what you and I once had. And no, it's not love, but it's not bad. Hey, no, it's not love. It's not like ours was. It's not love, but it keeps love from driving me mad. Hey, now I don't have to wonder who she's had. But it's not. not bad. I turn to her when you leave me alone. Sometimes even when you're here, but you're still gone. Now we still don't have what you and I once had. And no, it's not love, but it's not bad. Hey, no, it's not love. It's not like ours. Now it's not love, but it keeps love driving me mad. Hey, and I don't have to wonder who she's had. But it's not bad. You know it's not love, but it's not bad.
Ah, the Hag.
Man, you know, I've had JD and James and all those guys fill in here, and every one of them talked about you.
Is that right?
And of course,
it's,
I mean,
true. It is definitely true.
Isn't it, Danny? It absolutely is.
I love those
is.
Guys.
And there's a reason, because your voice is like, I swear to God, it's like a punch. It hurts your feelings. It literally punches your feelings.
It hurts your feelings.
It's so strong, man. And
your voice hurts my feelings.
Yeah, your voice. Your words really insult me, but your voice hurts my feelings.
That's good.
No, man.
I really appreciate that. And those guys, I love those guys, and I really appreciate it.
Well, you know, and I appreciate everybody bringing you into the fold, because, you know, I
glad to be here.
Yeah, it's so good to have you here, man, and just to hear you sing and to hear these great songs, country music.
Right.
Which, you know, you really got to look for nowadays, you know.
It's very tough to find.
It's tough to find, but you definitely are keeping it alive with what you do, and you always have, of course. And, you know, the wheel would not have been the wheel without you. You know, the wheel would have been missing a spoke.
Had a lot of nights I don't remember down there. But yeah.
Yeah, right. Yeah. I have one.
I have one.
My wife's over there glaring at me. She's like, yes, you do.
All right. We're going to do another original here, I guess.
Yes, sir.
I wrote with Corey Batten.
I can't see the key. Is it in D? D? Yes? Okay.
One, two, three.
I take Route 405 sometimes on my way home. It's a little out of my way, but that's the way I go. There's a patch of wildflowers that grow summer, fall, and spring. And my baby's big on the little thing. Rise and shine with the morning sun, yeah, long before she does. I head downstairs to the kitchen and I grab her baby cup. Her sweet kiss wakens up that coffee that I bring. Yeah, my baby's big on the little thing. A little white frame wedding chapel and a little white dress her grandma made. A little house with a little extra room for some little ones someday. A long, long vow that I'll be keeping in that tiny diamond ring. Yeah, my baby's big on the little thing. To pick up that cell phone for no reason and no rhyme, just to remind her that she's always on my mind. I smile just thinking of her smiling when it rings. baby's big on the little thing. A little white frame wedding chapel and a little white dress her grandma made. A little house with a little extra room for some little ones someday. A lifelong vow that I'll be keeping in that tiny diamond ring. Yeah, my baby's big on the little. Little white frame wedding chapel and a little white dress her grandma made. A little house with a little extra room for some little ones someday. A lifelong vow that I'll be keeping in that tiny diamond ring. Yeah, my baby's big on the little. My baby's big on the little. My baby's big on the little thing. Big on the little thing.
Oh, big on the little things right there. Wrote that with Corey Batten.
That's such right. Good stuff, man. Yeah, has it ever great. Been on hold? Has any of this ever been?
That one, no.
Never, man, never. Alive.
Some of these have, but that one, no.
That is an undiscovered jewel right there. You could literally turn the music business around with a song like that. Seriously.
I would love it. Let's do it.
Well, hurry up, man.
With your voice. With it.
Yeah, absolutely, man. You know, I remember just watching you play and just listening to you just, like, wail this stuff out. But the difference when people watched you play to watching other people play, everybody else was like, you know, that thing. They watch you, they were like, they were just, like, in awe. You know,
well, I appreciate it. You're embarrassing.
Well, you know, I mean, it's just awesome, man.
I appreciate that.
It's a bunch of credit that you've deserved for a long time, and I don't know if you've ever gotten it or not, but you should be because it's absolutely amazing.
I appreciate that a lot coming from y'all, you guys.
And it's not laying it on thick. I mean, I'm going easy afterward. I'm just gonna be like,
all right.
Do the sweet little hurt, little swing thing.
Oh yeah.
All right, I wrote this with Roger Springer and Paul Bogart.
I like living my life just as simple as I can. I never think about today, that's always my plan. I'm just a regular kind of guy, there ain't no doubt. As a matter of fact, there's only one little thing that ever made me stand out, and that's her. Sweet little her. A cute little dress and a crown, turn your head right around, that's her, yeah. She's my lady, she's my baby. It's easy to see, the best part of me is sweet little her. Everyone else, I've had my bad days. I come home mad at the world, cause nothing's gone my way. And just when I think it's more than I can have, at the end of the rope, there's only one I know who can cut me a little slack, and that's her. That sweet little her. A cute little dress and a crown, turn your head right around, that's her. She's my baby, she's my lady. It's easy to see, the best part of me is sweet little her. That's her, sweet little her. A cute little dress and a crown. Turn your head right around, that's her, yeah. She's my baby, she's my lady. It's easy to see, the best part of me is sweet little her. Sweet little her.
Country swing stuff.
Just like we rehearsed it 87 times. Do the ending for me one more time. One, two, three, four. Just to show that I know it. No, that was great, man. That was awesome. You know, and the Western swing thing, of course, you know, you like Keith Whitley and all that good stuff. It's I don't want to say you do what he does. It's like you keep him going. You know what I mean?
One of my biggest influences.
Yeah, you keep that going. You keep that vibe going that you just can't get it anywhere else, you know? And I appreciate it for more than just you keep it going. I appreciate it because you're keeping something that just people can't get anywhere anymore, you know? It's not
radio
out there.
Radio don't play it.
No, and there's not a whole lot of crooners out there that do just such a beautiful job like you do, man. And I really do appreciate it. I got to take a minute and say thank you to Prosperity Mortgage, Donnie Eden, for a great intro. Thank you so much, Donnie. We appreciate you being here. Folks, if you're in the market for a new house or you need to remortgage, talk to Donnie Eden at Prosperity Mortgage. And we want to thank the White House Pizza Pub. Did everybody get pizza?
Absolutely.
Everybody got it? Nashville Hot, Perry's. What else did we have? We had another one. Cutlass or something like that. A veggie. All right. That was a veggie? My God, it was every vegetable in the grocery store on that thing. I thought that was like the deluxe. All right. White House Pizza Pub. All right. Thank you, sponsors. We appreciate it very much for keeping us going. So we're going to do another one. What do you got?
I'm going to hurt her on the radio.
Oh.
Got another Keith Whitley coming up here. Speaking of Keith Whitley. One of my favorites by him. Which Charlie Pride actually had a cut on as well. And,
that's what I heard. I'd never heard this version.
I think Shenandoah did it as well.
Did they really?
I'm pretty sure. And the Bellamy Brothers did it too.
Really?
Yeah, I was looking up versions and I saw their version too.
Oh, man. It's the only one I'd ever heard. And like I was telling you guys earlier, I remember back in the 90s when Charlie Pride's version came out that they had to sit there. They had the radio station call letters in it. You know, Q106.5 is going to let her know. Because I was in Bangor. I was in Maine. Yeah. And that Charlie Pride had to sit there for 3,000 radio stations and call them all up, you know. 99, I'm going to let her know. And he's probably like, all right, Charlie, next is 103.5. 103.5 is going to let her know.
That's right. There we go.
Righty. What are we doing?
I'm
gotcha.
The one with the radio stations all in it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. She's gonna hear me everywhere she goes. I'll get revenge the only way I know. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. I'll take these pieces of this broken heart. I'll watch him climb the country music chart. She's gonna pay me back in royalties. Pay for bringing me down to my knees. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. She's gonna hear me everywhere she goes. I'll get revenge the only way I know. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. I'm gonna tell the world the way she done me wrong. I'll make a million while she sings along.
Think she's heard the last of my love song. Maybe she won't feel that way for long. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. She's gonna hear me everywhere she goes. I'll get revenge the only way I know. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. I'm gonna get to her in stereo. I'll be hurting down inside, I know. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio. She's gonna hear me everywhere she goes. I'll get revenge the only way I know. I'm gonna hurt her on the radio.
Heath Whitley music right there.
Oh, man. I can't tell you what this is like. This is like bringing back so many memories. I feel like a kid again, you know? It's great. Do you do these songs always when you play out?
Most times, yeah.
Really?
Most times, yeah. All this kind of stuff. You know, a lot of Keith Whitley and a lot of Daryl Singleton.
Yeah.
That's just my style.
Well, I mean, that's, you know, that's, you own that.
I don't know. I appreciate it, but I love it. I know that.
I do love it. Man, I'm so glad to have you here and to hear some country music again. It does my heart good.
My pleasure. I appreciate you having me.
Absolutely, buddy.
All right, what do we got?
I'm going to do this song. This song is really special to me because I wrote it with the late, great Harley Allen, who's one of the best songwriters that's ever been in this town. And he passed away probably about a month after we wrote this song. He died of lung cancer. But I'm going to do this one for y'all. Figured it out, I gave it some thought. Another bad breakup, but it's not my fault. Now, I loved country music since I was a kid, and wanted to do what those country stars did. Now I blame Hank Williams, I cheating heart, and I blame old Toby for the way I love bars, and I thank Hank Jr. for all my rowdy friends, and old Willie puts me back on that road again. Now me and Merle Haggard were let down by the bottle. Yeah, I thank country singers, bad role model. Generation of starstruck young fools, they grew up thinking that those guys were cool. I guess it wasn't too bad, all the things that they did. At least they didn't decide to go jump off a cliff. Yeah, I blame Hank Williams for my cheating heart, I blame old Toby for the way I love bars, and I blame Hank Jr. for all my rowdy friends, and old Willie puts me back on that road again. Now me and Merle Haggard were let down by the bottle. Yeah, I think country singers make bad role models. Yeah, I think country singers, they make bad role models. I figured it out, I gave it some thought. Another bad breakup, but it's not my fault.
Yeah.
I just can't believe you wrote these songs. These are fantastic, man. Well, people need to hear it. Make sure you look up Jason Wagner's stuff on wherever you can find it. If it's
Facebook,
not on Spotify.
Facebook, Reverb Nation.
Facebook, Reverb Nation. All right, so Reverb Nation, it's up there. That's right. So they can find you there and spread the word because, I mean, it's just, it's awesome. It's absolutely awesome. What do we got? Another one more?
Millsap.
Oh, you got to end on a Millsap, dude. Yeah, when you said you were doing this one, I was kind of excited.
I love Millsap. He's one of the greatest. Called Smoky Mountain Rain.
Waved a diesel down outside a cafe. I said, those bright lights ain't where I belong. Hey, from a phone booth in the rain, I called to tell her I had a change of dreams, I'm coming home. The tears filled my eyes when I found out she was gone. On falling, I keep on calling her name. Smoky Mountain Rain, I keep on searching. I can't go on hurting this way. And she's somewhere in the Smoky Mountain Rain. Waved a diesel down outside a cafe. He said that he was going as far as Gatlinburg. I climbed up in the cab all wet and cold and lonely. I wiped my eyes and told him about her. I said, you got to find her. Can you make these big wheels burn? Woman needs someone warm to hold. I feel the rain running down my face. I'll find her no matter what it takes.
Jason, I can't tell you what a pleasure it was to have you here live from the shop, everybody. Scott Smith over there on the keys, everybody. Danny Muhammad on the steel and the guitar. Greg Lohman back there on the drums. Jason, my friend, thank you. I hope that you are out there pushing this stuff because it absolutely has to be heard. Danny, you got to stay on him.
I will stay on him.
We all got to stay on him. Let's get JD and James and all those guys to stay on. There needs to be a Jason Wagoner music food truck. We just bring it to everybody because it's so damn good, man. I'm not kidding. I know you're blushing, but you know, we got as much red light on you as we can to get rid of
that.
I'll
give you an hour to quit talking like that.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Make sure you look up Jason Wagoner, everybody. Right. It's absolutely awesome. It's so good to see you again, my friend. It was wonderful. It sounded fantastic, and we'll see you all next week on Live from the Shop, everybody.
Thank you all.